Okay, let's start. Hello, everyone. Welcome, and thank you for your presence, your online presence. I'm Pedro Carneiro, and I'm here to talk about tools and techniques used in agile innovation. Simple note about me. Commonly in agile teams, I use this personal map. I think that you already know it. It's a management 3.0 technique. It's the first tool that I speak to you. When we hire a new person, he fill the personal map and show to us. It's an amazing thing because it's more relevant the soft skills than the competencies. So mine was done here in mind map. The blur is intentionally, and the point is that we go walking from bound to bound. So it's not supposed to be, now we go to bound to bound. It's just a perspective that what you can have with personal maps. Okay, first I just say to you that I have two monitors, and when I look left, I'm watching the second monitor, so not worry. Tell you now that if you have any questions, use the raise your hand or put questions in the Q&A. So about me. As you can see, I get the text that was my presentation in the program course. I am from Braga, Portugal, north of Portugal. I am a founding partner director at We Make Information Technologies since 2002. I start as a developer, and then I stop developing and take the function of a project manager. I have here some stories to tell you about the process that I implement in the company, and why I shift not 100%, because agile is agile. If you love it, you get it for everything. I need to get a new area called WeSecure. I am the director of that area, that is from cybersecurity projects and forensics analysis. It's another path that I represent at WeMake, but this is not a company, this is a brand. I also I'm the DPO, Data Protection Officer in public and private, and I have these qualifications that I show you here. Of course, this slide is just for you to know my competence. So if you know me better, you know where I can add value to you. If you have any question, these qualifications are to help and support companies in these areas. We have here the 27005. It's risk management. So I'm certified in risk management for cybersecurity risks. Also for the 27032. That means guidelines for cybersecurity. 22301 means business continuity. That is most important in any company. I am lead auditor and lead implementer certified. And also 27001, that means information security management systems. We certify, I am auditor and implementer. Okay, and also 27701. So there are many standards that work around in cybersecurity area. Of course, maybe you ask why I'm here, because my last 5 years was more cybersecurity than agile. And in fact, my daily basis is a challenge because if you have agile, you don't have so much security. And if you have a lot of security, you have nothing from agile. So it's a balance that I have to help organizations to achieve. And it's my daily basis in the non-standard world. I'm happy with the two things. I start from Agile, as we will see. I'm here to share more the experience in Agile, of course. The experience that the Scrum is applied for software development. I use Agile methodologies, some artifacts from Scrum implemented in cybersecurity projects because they work, they help me getting projects, products or service in time, and the culture and the environment behaviors are amazing. So I'm here to try to share what I have to in my last 10 years in these areas. Okay. I will talk about agile innovation, the challenge and the problems and that I have experienced. I am a lucky guy because I have the opportunity to first to in 2012 starting try to start a project management methodology. I embrace Scrum and I don't know nothing about it, and I want to my company in place, but I don't have nothing, so I take a certification course from certified Scrum Master. I say I'm lucky because I have the opportunity to change the mindset to put the company producing more with more quality, with value to customers, with the deadlines finally achieved, and the happiness of the people. So I'm here to share with you that things. I don't know. I don't know the maturity level of Agile in your organizations. I don't know if you are here and you don't know what is Scrum or Agile. You have an idea, of course. I don't know if you are implementing Agile in a higher maturity level. Of course, I can put here a poll to know that, but the slides are done. So I try exactly to walk from the beginning to 100 digital agile platforms. I must confess that any tool, any platform, I try even show you platforms that we don't use that we make because I don't have any interest in showing this one or another one. I put the reference of everything. You will have this. So feel free to see which one is the best for you and the best fit. Of course, many doubts are arriving after the session. Like my classes, I teach project management since 2010 in computer engineering courses. And in the Master of Computer Science and Cybersecurity Master. But to tell you that even in cybersecurity, I use agile methodologies in the class. So everything is good if you feel feedback and satisfaction. So I will try to use some storytelling and clear concepts. But any doubt, please again raise your hand and use the chat question and answers. I must confess that it was for me the first time that I will speak about Agile in a unidirectional way. I don't see you, No webcams, of course. I don't know who are you. I do not will have feedback, but it's a challenge, so I am here to try to help you. As you can see, there are some risks of my presentation, of course. If I am certified in risk assessments, I think I need to make a risk of this webinar. And the risk is that I will, the invitation, and thank you again for the invitation to Professor Almeida. Because he invited me to talk about agile innovation tools and techniques in agile innovation, and my comfort zone is Scrum. So Scrum is not the only agile framework, but maybe sometimes my answers or my opinions are the Scrum based, okay? But I will try to explain for non-engineering, non-computer engineering development software companies and audience. My boring Port English, as you can see, I have difficult to express in English. I think I understand better, but I talk very badly, so apologize for that. Please always stop me in raise your hands if you don't understand my Port English, okay? And as I said, it's a unidirectional session, and it's a risk that maybe a thematic that you expect to be more evolved, and I jump to another one. So take notes, and at the end, please tell me what you need to know. Okay. Okay, I start, of course, but it's not the best definition, but when I see responsible innovation, we see two words. One is responsible and one is innovation. If I think that you need to choose one, I know what you choose. Of course, the opinion may be indexed by the maturity level of your age and so on, because responsible is also opportunity, and any opportunity has more risk. You need to be responsible, and maybe the other people choose innovation because it's a word with fashion. Here we need to embrace responsible innovation as it all in your management course makes sense nowadays. Comparing to technology, to the scope of technology that we embrace. And we are talking about many, many, many things, the digital ways we live now, the new normal, and so on. So I tried for me to have two definitions, and this is interesting. So I just make a Google search and I find one, responsible. So being responsible means being dependable, keeping promise and honoring our commitments. It is accepting the consequence for what we say and do. Whoa, this is, I think, to remember me that, listen again, it is accepting the consequence for what we say and do. Okay, so when I got married, I promised my wife that it was me who always washed the dishes. So I was responsible, and then I bought her a dishwasher. And that's it. We stay hostage to what we say, and we expect the consequences. I must say that I have that responsibility in WeMate because I am a partner. And of course, this is really true. So it also means developing our potential. Okay, this is a random definition. And innovation. So innovation is, when I talk with my students, because I teach very much the part of the process, inputs, outputs, activities, different techniques, and so on. Sometimes we need to talk about innovation process. And in the beginning, I asked always what they understand, what is the definition of innovation. Of course, you are bored since this week, you have seminars talking about innovation, but I like to share with you one about 10 years I heard, and it's in my mind forever. But when I ask the students, or if I ask you, maybe the answer should be innovation is do new things, do what had not been done yet. It's like a Portuguese music. Is recreate something, is take the old and make it new. It's automation, is improvement, and effectively is everything like that. The definition I love is this one. This is from Pravin Gupta. I love this definition that I heard in presence of Pravin Gupta in a seminar keynote speaking about understanding the mystery of innovation. I was there, and he said that if you do what people like, you are innovating. And at the time, 2009, 10, 2010, he used the iPhone as an example of innovation product. He said it's so beautiful, great touch, but too much expensive to make phone calls. And people like the product, they buy it. Today, maybe we can say that if you love autonomous driving, I love that, but my wife don't. So the advantage is to go around alone. Maybe we can say we have innovation in Tesla cars. They are like a mobile phone with wheels. Yeah, I think it's that. I think it's that. We have another concepts like Uber Innovation, the biggest fleet management company without any car, Airbnb or booking platform, big companies about hosting without any houses. So why they use that is because they like, and they use, so they use, they grow. If they grow, they improve, and so on, like Facebook. And some people like, others don't. I respect that. But if you like, we innovate. I take this message to my company, inside my company. It is similar to Agile, because Agile is return of value, not return of investment. And for me, if I do something for you and you like it, I feel that I'm adding value to you. Okay? So I hope this presentation is not a waste of time for you. I found many frameworks. I have here one because it's not only that definitions, you already studied this. Responsible innovation aspires to be human-centered and environmentally friendly and invest in future relationship with key stakeholder groups to drive technology adoption based on delight and trust. We have here many important terms like stakeholder, key stakeholders, trust, safe, norms, laws, market. So ALCA frameworks put responsible innovation at the center of the development technology. And of course, the technology, development technology, will need some norms. The part, I think that the ethics, it's a big problem in digital world. My company is digital. We work in digital transformation, and I think there is no ethics. Start in cybersecurity, privacy, it start to have guidelines and regulations and laws. But there are ambiguous today, okay? And I think ethics and privacy should have a council. It's not, if I say innovation is do what we like, Am I the right to create a glasses that if I look at you, I see you naked? I see you in tattoos, and you don't have tattoos. I see, and with machine learning and artificial intelligence, it's correct that I look at you and the interpretation of your body, and we can see more things than what we are seeing. What about ethics about this one? It's a great product, it's fantastic, or not, of course not, but sometimes it's a weapon. So, what about ethics, laws, norms? No. So, this is important. Okay, the first thing we need to reflect is where are we? How companies will consider this challenge and concerns on the present? We have many, many, many technologies. These are growing very, very, very fast. We can have here a chart, and you can see, of course, and you feel the evolution of this. I love the slides and the charts and the books from Gerd Lerner, a futurist, and I recommend you see some things about his talks. We'll see a video. But what challenge companies face today? I can close my company from one day to another. That's why we go to cybersecurity. We're developing software since 2002. But today, in any company, software is, if it's not audited with penetration testing, specialized techniques, security code reviewing. You are using your company software that have vulnerabilities that permits someone from outside access and destroy everything. So, what challenge we are facing today? So sometimes we need to adapt to the change very quickly, like COVID and pandemic. That's why I say COVID transformed the risk into opportunity for our company, for example, because we are in IT sector. But have the company's agility to overcome to digital trends? It was easy, it was not. Okay, let's see. The VUCA, like we, I know you talk about that. I know it's forever, the VUCA world, but some statements that it's important. Gerd Lerner says that the next 20 years will bring more change than the previous 300 years. Science fiction is becoming science facts. Anything that can be automated, digitized, or virtualized will be. When artificial intelligence meets human intelligence, it's the end of routine work as we know it. Whatever it is for a computer is art for humans and vice versa. And this will remain true for the foreseeable future. The human part, it's very important. Today we offer service in company. We help, we add value about the robotic process automation, for example. That means that the people doesn't do the boring tasks. It's a value, but it's a value for the people. If I do all the day boring tasks and someone make me a bot and do it for me precisely, it's amazing if I don't get fired, right? So it's important the inside responsible innovation, this kind of mindset, and to what do you do to the people? That people are free for innovation, okay? The robots don't innovate, the robots automate and robotize, okay? So this is an important thing, and I have here a video to see why the ultimate job is to be a human. It's 5 minutes, but it's a good, good, good movie. Oh, sorry. It's not Portuguese. It's really English. Okay, sure, the best part you've heard, it's work 3 hours a day for the same money. That will happen to us, the machines doing the, and other things, and the tax automation and so on. But some of these things we already see, the paper use, the software license means that it's better if you pay license, it's better you pay the clicks from the software you use. We are changing many things. So back to our Earth, Gerd, Leonard also speaks in other thematics, the important in agile of the measure, not the KPIs, but also the key human indicators, because the power of the humans, as you know, companies are the people, and we talk about that. Some considerations here. Today, business world is constantly bombarded with turmoil and unpredicted change that we see. This makes it very difficult for organizations to accurately predict possible future opportunities and threats. To overcome this scenario, organizations need to fully embrace and implement agility in their operations. The last one, we are not going back to normal. Resilience, agility, and creativity will beat everything else. And I think this, it's, we need to think about this one. Okay, so challenge. When people talk to me, how do I implement agile? How do we innovate in my company? What is the requirements? Of course, the first thing we need to know is how we work. Can we describe how we work? Which is our company vision, context, stakeholders? Did I work about supported process documentation? Or there are documented process that tell me how I need to work and I don't use them. This is important to know the context. All standards have the requirement in about the context. This is not one size fits all. It's for your companies. So depends on context. Okay. So what is agile? Agile is a mindset, a way of thinking, and a collection of values around our work should be organized in a complex and ever-changing world. So getting this agile definition, that's why we say commonly that Scrum is a set of meetings that you can run with your team. And one important objective is to cultivate the agile values. If you don't put in practice the agile values, we don't have agility. Okay. Of course, if we search more and more about agile, there is also a concept of modern agile that's try to stay off of the computer engineering software, development software, project management software, and so on. So modern agile is a community for people interested in uncovering better ways of getting awesome results. It leverages wisdom from many industries, is principle driven and framework free. So this is followed by that four principles. So more challenge that we need to face. Agile culture, it is an opportunity for reboot. Considering that I commonly say, we talk about this sentence many times. The only constant in our life is the permanent change, because in fact we are in a VUCA world. I don't like the Gantt charts because they fail. That's not true. In a project, they are amazing for a baseline, a perspective, a timeline, but in practice, we cannot guarantee that will be like that. We seek, we have risks, and so on. So the only constant in life is the permanent change. And have we a new challenge in responsible innovation, a new mission, working in a way that benefits both the employer and the organization? So we have many challenges driving to agile culture and implementation in companies. First, I like like I said in the beginning, I don't know exactly the maturity level of your agile in your organizations. So please, any question, we will start to see the understanding of the words, tools, and techniques because they are exposed in many articles and guidelines. Any question, please tell me. The
Pedro,
under yes.
I'm sorry, we're not seeing the presentation.
No.
No, we're not seeing the presentation.
No.
Yes, now it's okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. But you saw the video?
I'm not sure. I believe so.
Okay. That's a problem because the record session will not. But I give the slides to everybody, right? Okay. I'm sorry for that and thank you for that. So, as I'm telling, it's important to understand the term tools and techniques. What is this? So, for example, here in PMBOK, Project Management Body of Knowledge is a standard with a guideline with the best practice in project management for any scope. It's not only for software development. We see the inputs, then the tools and techniques, and then the outputs. It's normally it's a concept of a process. So we have tool and techniques that I will get the inputs and get the outputs. Here, this is the development project management plan. So this helped to get all the people knowing what to do when they have to do a project plan. So they need that inputs. They can use one of the tools and techniques, and they choose and then get the outputs. So that's what we will be see now. I like to define the definition of, sometimes as we will see, the Scrum have a beautiful scene, that definition of, so definition of tools. So for IT people, tool means a software, a platform, an application that do something. For my grandfather, a tool is a hammer. So the definition of, the perception of, it's important to have. Of course, some terms are clear, like software, hardware, Tupperware, and so on, and we don't need the definition of. But I'm reading the Q&A from Cipriano, and I don't see the message. Sorry for that. But now we are seeing my video. Okay. So the challenge, start an agile culture. If the presidents here are not working in an agile company, what they have to do, it's easy, it's difficult. Of course, it's a challenge. They have risks. And I tell you that I am lucky because I need to assume the risks and measure each risk and keep going or not. And thanks God, I keep going, and today everybody is happy, like you will see. So starting agile culture, some tools and techniques, of course, awareness. We need to embrace an agile mindset. There are many, many videos about that. There are 4 values and 12 principles of the art of the agile. Of course, they are created for software engineers, but it's easy to understand that videos. Invite teams to talk about resilience, because this impact, okay, the resilience, again, definition of resilience, for me, it's the impact resistance, like COVID, we survived, so we are resilient. And best definition from resilience for me, it's when a drop of glass cup go to the ground, it bounces, and doesn't break. That is resilience, okay? The invite people to experience a new change. Everything is new. Stand-up meetings, the meetings, the way of communication, the shield that protect the people who are in a sprint goal or a commitment. Everything is new. Of course, here I put the ACE acronym. I heard it on a digital transformation seminar. Means agile, connect, and engage. And the word engage is very, very important. Connect, I can ask you, which from you are connect to my Zoom meeting? And you raise your hand because you are connect. But which of you are engaged is different, okay? In a company of human resource, they say, we are a radical company. We love people, radical people to work with us. About Connect, the human resource director asked the people, do you want to work with the radical, in a radical company? And everyone raised the hands up. And because we are a radical company, you will work in with snakes. Are you engaged to work with snakes? And some people work raise the arms, and he open a door, and the people go down past the door. Everything is dark. We saw cameras, infrared cameras with snakes with elastics in the mouth. They measure the heart rates, and that people are successfully hired. Okay, so that's important. Let's just say I mean, I am the team, I should be part of the team, I go, I do, and just for talking, okay? Another thing important is also anticipate the trends, because like we see in the video, these are changing many very, very, very fast. So we need to anticipate the trends. We need to, no matter what kind of business your companies are, if you are a simple student, if you are, because if you are a student, you will be, can you create a spin-off and partnership? If you are a CEO, and so on, because the trends are very, very important. I share with you one preoccupation for me. In seminar, I was sit down there and I see this slide. Software is eating the world. And because I have a software company, I stay very happy. I see this slide and then I say, wow, we are in the right path. We are responsible, we are innovation in the right area. And it's not true, because when the keynote speaker talks, he's right. He's saying that any company in the world will produce software. So what he wants to say is that if you go to academic university, the person who is there can drag and drop some forms, and she don't care where the database is, Oracle, MySQL, she don't care. She do a software with low code and you have an application, okay? So this message, I come to Portugal and then I need to have a meeting with all of the people and reflect with these trends, and they have to decide what we need to do. I must say that in my business, we have two legs, but we need three. Like humans, if you have two legs and if you lose one, you cannot walk. Of course, you can have a bucket. But if you have three legs and you lose one, you can walk normally. So it's important. This is the concept of business continuity. And but it's important for us to go higher. Gui Kawasaki from Apple, he said, find the next curve. So it's important. Then we, in an agile, in a VUCA world, are always trying to assure the happiness of the company and the workers, of course. Okay, more. Teamwork. It's important when you implement agile innovation in your company, it's not just to say, now we are agile. It's important, the engagement, the teamwork. For example, in a class someday, in the first day, a student asked me, sorry, in this curricular unit is physically required my presence? And I say, why? Because otherwise I didn't come and I can fetch the PowerPoint slides. And I say, okay, if you are happy with that, no problem. But if your absence damage your team, the whole team will be damaged. And he quickly answer me, oh, okay, it's better to come. So this is the mindset, because the teams works together. Everyone needs, our multidisciplinary teams, like gamification, and they compete one with each other. And I'm saying that this is not for Scrum, for software companies, okay? I work I'm director in a Red Cross delegation and non-governmental companies, and we have many problems because, as you know, we cannot have the possibility to have, like high-perform organization, the people, high-perform organizations like Google and Apple and so on, they have the type of the person's balance, okay? One day, a consultant of high-perform organizations come to my company, and the only thing it was measured our types. If I was relational, creative, methodical, and in fact, at the end, he said, the next person for hiring should be a creative. Okay, and it's important to understand the profiles of the people, because if I know that the for example the Cipriano is a relational guy, I need to live with that. I know he want, then if I open the window, I can say first, Cipriano, can I open a window? Please, don't mind, it's okay for you, because he's relation, many relational profile, okay? So it's important the autonomy, the no fingerprint. So if you fail, no problem, you will see. And one amazing thing, response versus react. It's very important, this definition. We sometimes, I heard this in that seminar, we saw a video with a beer. The team, the company team are in the mountain, and quickly appear a beer, a big beer, tiger. And some people stay shocked, they react, they don't do nothing and say, ah, beer, a real beer, it's an animal. And other people try to run and escape. Then appears the human that threat the beer to stop, to, because it's a simulation, of course, but it's a real beer. So what the conclusion of this story? It's that we need to respond and not react. I saw that every day. You will see in your home. I said to my son, son, turn off the light of the dining room. And he reacts, he said me, he tell me, it was not me who turned it on, but what I want is a response. He shut down the turn off the light. I see that in company, sometimes I see a developer, we arrive on email, but the mail was sent for 3-4 people, and he think that, another one responds. That's a reaction. It's better to respond and not do like that. So agile have this problem because we love the simple things. And when we see other companies, other industries don't do governmental institutions, don't do the simple way, we stay badly, okay? So response is very important, the action. Sometimes here at home I say, agile. So that means quicky and easy, not friction, okay? So another beautiful term, I said to my students also, that show or die. Show or die is a very important term, because you could do the best, you are the best skills you have, but it's not looking to you that we see that competence, soft skills is important also, many, very, very important. I tell the students, if you do, if you have volunteered, if you have, if you was a delegate of the classes, if you are a singer, put that in your CV. Because companies need that, that if you are in scouts, if you are responsible, put that things, because that it's important. In my company, if we do something great, we need to stop everyone and show, because it's better to die, okay? So how do we show or die in our company? We're using visual boards, of course. That photo is the first board. Then when I take the tape and fill the wall so many arrows, the stories are to Iger. So this is just a smile photo for us. Then the transparency, it's appear when I look to the boards today, digital boards, of course. I will talk that next. But when I go to the company, I look to the left and to the right. And to the left, it's the to-do things. And if there are very, very, very things, we are late. In the right, it is the done column. And if we are quick, achieving the deadline, it is done. So the question is, what about the new normal? Of course, can you have these boards physically, digitally, virtually? And it's difficult for us to maintain, because we have Scrum things since 2015. And it's important not to let the things down. Learning lessons about the new normal. 2020 is now on our rear view. Teams and organizations should reflect on lessons learning. It's important, the retrospective, we call it Scrum. Let's make a retrospective about what's happened. So this agile guide I reference here says sit down with teams and individuals and listen to what they have to say. And many things happen in this new normal, okay? But know what whatever you decide, Agile can help your teams and organization navigate through the transition and behind. Let's dig into the biggest challenge distributed teams face and look at how Agile can provide solutions to some of the most common challenges in the galaxy. Yeah, it's, should we go to digital? We in other seminars that I saw, my colleagues talk with the truth about the distributed teams, because of the different time sizes in time zones and the cultures. That was great working from everywhere, but we have many challenges here about this. About digital tools, of course, if you go digital, you need to have the tools you need. And again, there is no one size fits all solution. It's each company needs to have the digital platform for communication, for meetings, for brainstorming, for estimation, and so on. I have here some examples. Like I said, I don't use this. It's just for the I use the others, but it's not no kind of interest, commercial interest, of course. So, but you, just to have an idea about the tools of digital that you can use to implement Agile remotely and work remotely. There are applications for brainstorming, research and design, vote priorized teams to discuss together. This is great also, a space for every team, digital tools to plan and track the progress, and find the best fit, of course, just search. I put here a search in the last month, and there are many tools. I read some scientific articles about the advantage and disadvantage of some tools. I meet companies, they love the behavior, the human behavior. They don't like the software. They want to look to the people in the daily, in the meetings. And that's important. You choose what you intend to choose. And what about the physical boards? I put this slide here because we have a difficult synchronization. It was the fail wall. We have, I see this from Spotify culture, and I love it. And also from the Jeff Sutherland, they speak in their books. The fail wall, that post-its you see there are the things that the people fail. So if you have a culture that fail is beautiful, fail is great, no matter who, the point is, if you fail fast, you can learn fast with the failure and improve fast. So in software, as you understand, it's very important, this situation. Jeff Sutherland, the co-creator of the Scrum, also talks about this, about the Japanese cars and the German cars. So the autonomy that a Japanese employer have to stop the line production if it detects a defect, it's the gold. So in WeMake, we also have this. When we find a failure, it can be Failure of development, failure of security problems, the problems with the teams. When we have a failure, we stop everyone and go here and put the post-it. This is more difficult to put in digital, just because one thing, because it's a wall that is attractive reading board. Because I think it promotes curiosity. If you go with me in my company and I leave you, of course you can read the columns and maybe the fail wall you read more precisely. And it's amazing that no matter who fails. I have a boring story, true, last Monday. So in the sprint planning meeting, a colleague, our colleague, fainting, he falls, and I put a post-it in the fail wall. Why? Because he have the webcam turned on, and the falls, we stay like we are here. If I fall now, maybe Katarina try to understand what's happening, may call me, no answer. It's an urgent situation and we have emergency contacts, and the fail wall takes a post-it saying from today it's important, it's a requirement to have a webcam turned on in the meetings. Of course there are privacy concerns, but we are talking in planning meetings. And I take that example and improve fast, and everyone understand that, okay? So this wall is amazing for us, not so easy to go to digital. Of course, I can create a call in a dashboard online, but maybe the curiosity and this wall and this board is near the walking on bar. So another one, improve communication. So for me, communication is key. It's key to add value, no doubts. There is no doubt, any doubt. Agile is based in return of value, not return of investment, like I told you. And if the teams communicate many times, they maintain the focus. So that's a problem in pandemic stage, that if you don't, the interaction, so many interaction, you maintain the focus. If you don't have interaction, the focus can be lost. So if the teams communicate many times, they maintain the focus. Here Alcatraz, right? I put this Alcatraz in the prison. And do you know why? Because I see a documentary that in National Geographic that the fact that they change the canteen tables because they are long, and they put new ones to separate those that are allowed for seats. So that change of the furniture of the tables allow the prisoners to have concentrated meetings every day, two or three times per day, in the same seats, in the same table, with the same guys, and to fine tune the strategy to scale. Communication is important. That's why in Scrum we need to respect. We need to have the daily stand up meeting. It's stand up to be fast. It cannot be more than 15 minutes. I use some other like Microsoft the term park. That it's important, park. The old people know that to move a laptop needs to park, to use the command park in the old computers. And why park that? Because it's common and healthy to discuss problems in the meeting. But we need to stop that, and we say park that, and then we continue. We feel we go along with the meeting, and it's important. What is important to know what the people have done? I can ask here to Paul what you have done last meeting, not yesterday, because if today is Monday, it will be really a story, a big story. What Paul have done since last meeting, what he expected to do today, and if there is an impediment. Because I act as a Scrum Master. Scrum Master is a facilitator, is a person who try to get the consensus with the people, the balance, and resolves the process and people's problems. And the people talk about that. All the team heard, all the team know what happened, what will happen today, and that communication is success. I can tell you that in my house also. Sometimes tonight, in the night, I say to my wife, oh, you only arrive now? Only now? And sometimes she tell me, oh, because I need to go to take our son and our daughter, and then I come to house. And I say, why don't you tell me? Because I pass near. If you have tell me, I have passed there. So when we in the morning or in the lunch talk, what we will do, what is expected, if it is an impediment for today, we increase agility and satisfaction, and everything it's better. Okay, so. Communication is key. Of course, the communication in for example, in cybersecurity projects and implementation projects, they also are complemented in the process with the RASI matrix. I think you know that the RASI matrix is amazing because it's needed to define the RASI. So RASI means who is responsible, who is accountable, who is consulted, and who is informed. So it defined it, and it's more easy to don't fingerprint. Fingerprint is another thing. Another problem in our area in projects. So if you have a company, not a software company, that produce something with projects, we need projects. A product or a service, you need projects, then you need to the estimation. Of course, if the product is the same, the process, the project, it's clear. It's there is you make sure the business continuity of the machines to produce the components or the product, but you must be prepared for the VUCA world, right? Because things happen. So it's for us, we are a software company, it's difficult to estimate. It is, I must confess that I take the 3 days of the Scrum course, and I don't speak nothing of metrics. And from 1 week to another, I put everything in my company is talking in story points. And the seller man doesn't understand how the team who developed the product says that this project takes 1,000 points, and he asked me, but what about cost? What about days? What about planning? What about deadline? What I do with that? And it's amazing to discover these things. Amazing to today we only use story points because we test it. We do an exercise, and we have adventures in the buffer because we get the team velocity. And if one element doesn't achieve the goal in the metrics, the another achieve, and it's more. The teams achieve the goal normally before the deadline. So, but this is just a sample. I read an article one day, and I don't know the name, but it's amazing because scientific proof of the being human doesn't know very well to estimate, but it's perfect in comparing. So and it's true. If I tell you, not here but physically, if I tell you that in my department, if I say my height is 1 meter and 70 centimeters, and ask what is the height average of our team, and the people look from the left and the right, and basically should give an interval of values that will be very, very, very comparing terms and very, very successfully achieve the results. So using this principle, there is a technique called planning poker. This is not used only for Scrum framework. I start to implement in a private social solidarity institution. And some class take care of babies. So we need to agree what is the deck 1 point. And if it is change the baby's diaper or is take care of the baby's hair, we need to agree. And that's 1 point. So if I, that's why some cards like this one you are seeing here have fruits, have dogs, dog points, fruits, because it's the human being can easily compare a cherry from a pineapple with the size. Okay, so this is amazing to talk about this, but for people who don't know the process of the estimation, it's very difficult to understand what I'm saying. So I just want to know that the briefing is about planning poker. If you ask me how many times I take to develop a website, maybe I say 10 days, but how did I say 10 days? 10 days and not 20 days? So if we have experience in determining that 1 point means I have either, or I put 10 points means the effort, for I put an image in the site. So if I know the site takes 100 image, it's simple to get the total points. And then if I have the total points, I need to measure with my team how many days we get in total points. But that is not good, because the Parkinson law I have in the next slide. Because if you say, take the days you want and tell me until you achieve the 100 points. We know that Parkinson law says this. The task takes the long, expands to the time that are allowed. And it's true. You know that in project management, you have the Parkinson law and the student syndrome. And there are two big problems in projects. So that's true. If I tell you that you have 1 hour to clean your room, you in 1 hour clean your room. But if I say you have 1 day to clean your room, so the task expands until the time allowed. So in the estimation of planning poker for the first time, so if you try to test Scrum, the team need to define how much points do you do in 5 days. That's called the sprint size. For example, my error was get the stories and achieve the 100 points. So what we have to do, okay, 100 points, I do 10 today, 12 tomorrow, and so on. After the last day, we see that the team achieve 120 points, for example. Okay, So, and this it's so the first time we do 120 points, then the second week we do 80 points, and the third week we do 200 points, and so on, and we get the team velocity. But if I change any member, of course I need to measure again. Okay, I'm difficult to talk about this if you don't know, don't use the planning poker, or if you already know planning poker, the discussion should be another one, but okay. Remember that I am always, you have my contacts, and I'm always free to take your doubts. So another big problem is when estimate. So why? Because the Scrum with the Agile methodologies, the best thing is that we agree to do this in this week, because we know that at the end of this week we have a review we need to show to the customer, and it's not correct. I have a team in this week doing the work agreed for all, untouchable. They are doing what we untouchable, but of course the VUCA world, we need to replace something. The customers say, don't do the reports, do the search function. Okay, he priorized, we add value to the customer because he wants to change, and it's not good have a team compromised with that goal. And I call, hey, I have a phone call. I need to let you to estimate because it's a software and you are the best fit for estimation. And from the other side, they tell me, but our team are compromised. So I write here that the insured team have time to help you. It's very important. And for example, when I have a request for proposal, like I told you, or someone calls me, then I need to appreciate if it is compliance, if it is compliance need, risk, how many risks it will be the project, just in the high level, not many focus on the high level. That's responsible innovation, because if I take my team to estimate a project, I will have problems about the deadlines in where they are. So what is estimation cost effort, because it's different. And I think that sometimes here the best way is to have buffer zones. Imagine I have a story with 8 points in my sprint that are for estimation purposes, and my team have 7 people. So if anyone have 8 points, okay, we will have time to estimate, because I am not a developer, I'm not the product owner, I'm not the sellerman. But in project in cybersecurity, I am, and I need to give feedback to the customer. Some customers ask me, tell me how much, the planning, the resources, 3 things, time, cost, and resource, time, cost, and resources. And I want to do the project. And I cannot wait for the teams in Scrum. They are in the Scrum goal. Okay, so I need to have buffers to ensure the team have time to help me when I need, okay? And what happened if I don't need them? Of course, Agile have many answers for this. It's like the beta tester. What a beta tester do when we kick off a project? We don't have nothing to test. In the Audi factory, they call these guys the gray heads. So when a gray head with a very experienced don't have nothing to do, we will do training for the newbies. Okay, so beta tester in the beginning can start analyzing, doing functional analysis, preparing the tools, check the manuals, and so on. Okay. Okay, and one important thing is sometimes for estimation that is not clear, and the Scrum, the Agile methodology say if it's not clear, don't do. It's like we go to a restaurant, take pizza, and the employer comes and I say, oh, I want pizza, but I don't know if I want with oil, with jam, and if he doesn't know, he cannot make the production of that. So here in our life it's the same, and it's difficult because sometimes we need to have a meeting with the customer to understand what he needs, and in remotely it's better because we are quickly online. We come inside a Zoom meeting, an online meeting, and assist. But again, that person who come with me in the meeting, that is not planned. It is planned because he have a ticket, like a buffer ticket, okay, like a pillow. Stay comfort, don't worry, I will need you, but the project doesn't go bypass the deadline. Okay, another problem is the communication of the estimated times. This is a big problem, okay? Because sometimes we make an effort to estimate. And for example, if I say the salesman 40 hours, the salesman says to the client 1 week. And I say, what? Really? You produce 8 hours per day? Are you sure? It's 40 hours, 1 week? Could not be 2 weeks working only in the morning. Are the team available in that time? Are the available team the best fit for that requirement, the project? Is this any non-working day, holidays in that week? So the first error is 8 hours per day. We don't work 8 hours per day. Okay, maybe we can have a timetable to work, but we talk, we take coffee, so it's wrong when you speak in hours. Okay, so I don't like if salesmen communicate directly to my dev team about hours, I'll spoil. Okay, that Scrum is rigorous, and we need to respect it. Okay, about the Scrum Poker, the planning poker, also we have some tools, of course, online. These have some rules. We need to avoid the halo effect, okay? Halo effect means that if, for example, Paul are with me, works in my company since 20 years, and for example Philips come last week, if I ask for the estimation of the requirement, it's not normal that if the poll choose 8 points, and of course Philips will choose 8 points because I arrived yesterday. If he is here from 20 years and say 8 points, who am I to say less than other things than 8 points? So it is important, the halo effect, this is roles, they need to change the points in the same time. If the points are very disparate with more than one cars, I forgot to say that is commonly we use the Fibonacci numbers, so it's a relational mathematic formula, and that was the snails are created, the pineapple are created, the nature are created with Fibonacci numbers. So when we have the estimations from people are playing the card that are higher than one card, they need to justify. So if I have the Phillips shows 1 point and the Sylvie shows 8 points and the other shows 5 points, I need to give the explanations. I need to ask the explanations for the higher and the lower. And sometimes it's amazing. Sometimes we are, so I give 1 point because I do this yesterday. And the team say, okay, it's for you, no problem. And that's amazing, the discussion. The another thing, it's the discussion that means that the requirements are clear. So we make sure that what we'll send to production is clear, confirmed, agree, and no doubt. Okay, if there is doubt, we cannot estimate. We need to ask the client representative, the Scrum product owner. And when you have that, the declaration, all the team, it is clear, so we can estimate. Okay, for example, the client wants the notification. That is nothing because how is the notification? By mail, by SMS, by phone, by when he instant messaging, by when only when he log into the platform and have a pop-up with a message. How is the notification? So the team asks this. We don't know what clients expect, so we go to the product owner, to the client, and when it's clear, okay. Another application, okay. There are many informal wild phones. So in this end of the presentation, I would like to share some recommendations from Mural that they recommend in Agile Evolution ebook, electronic book, to face the new normal. First, effective collaboration. So of course, collaboration is a general characteristics of a successful team. So after the pandemic, everything changed. We need to adapt, no doubt of that. Okay. I said many times in lockdown period that being at home is all about work. We need to take care. We say here, however, workspace over workplace does come with challenge. It's important to not be boring with that. You know what I mean. And it's important to have rules and in-house or remotely, anywhere you are, you comply with the rules. The rules are to be complied, not to be imposed, and agreed at first, of course. Of course, if we are in digital, if we are remotely in my company, we will never go day by day, each day, to physically to the company, to the presence. So embrace a digital first infrastructure, of course. You have already many tools. Some highly productive distributed hybrid teams rely on infrastructure that is accessible from any location. And platforms like Slack, Mural, Jira, Teams, Zoom are recently work by allowing real-time and synchronous collaboration to efficiently take place. Of course, we can communicate everywhere, by phone, anywhere you are, okay? And no matter what you are doing, okay? If I have a worker that asks me, can I go 4 p.m. to gym? Why not? I measure results, no problem. Oh, but the problem is the client can call. Okay, but if he agree with the colleague in the team that I will, from the 4 to 5 o'clock p.m., I will forward my phone calls, okay? Okay, no problem. So that's we create our satisfaction, no problem with that. Okay. So, whether your team is newly formed or has been working together for a while, be available to, of course, in digital trends, we need the new normal. We need to come up with a team name, motto, and mission. So, the team names are amazing in America at the moment. They have many creativity. Assign roles and responsibilities, the RACI matrix, and of course, we need to know who is the owner of that task, who is responsible for validation, and so on. Normally in Scrum, the teams are autonomous. I commonly say that worse than doing nothing. Worse than doing wrong is doing nothing. Okay, so do something. If it's wrong, no problem. Choose metrics and KPIs and key HIs, like George Leonard say. Co-create values as norm as a team. You look ahead to events and key dates, anticipate that, and it's okay. Because sometimes the client says, we want the project until the end of the year. Okay, but definition of end of the year. We have a Christmas week. Oh, it's near 20 of December. Oh, your end of the day is 20. Okay. It's important to have that, because if not, we have problems with what we promise. So connection, that's a big challenge. Maintain the teams connected, especially when a distributed workforce spread work in different time zones and cultures. We have already heard this in the other seminars, because I heard that. I think it's Professor Almeida talk about this problem. Leaders, agile leaders and teams will have to develop strategies to help their teams to be connected. Fortunately, digital workspace built for collaboration and frameworks like Scrum have never been more available and easy to adopt. So it's more easy to communicate digitally than have meetings presentially. The suggestion of Mural, the company of Mural. I share the slides. You can get the Agile Evolution book from there. It's interesting, but it's one option in many others there. They propose a Scrum process into 100% digital way. Okay, so each thing, each ceremony that you do physically, you can do it's online, okay? For example, sprint planning meeting, okay? Everyone is connected, everyone are planning. Daily Scrum, we have the meetings, online meetings. Of course, this is important only when we have distributed teams with different time zones, because when in the other side of the globe they come to work and we are sleeping, and it's important to try to use technology, and it's sometimes I say in my company, use agile tools, don't write, just use the tools like speech to text or record a voice message or a video. It's internal. And of course, there are questions about privacy, where the file are located, the retention period, and so on. But again, we need to do it in a agile way. So we need to balance, to put in the balance. And of course, when there is a security control that conflicts with the production, we need to do a risk assessment, and the Scrum Master is the facilitator, try to gain the consensus, and sometimes it works. So there are not real solutions 100% perfect. So I love the Daily Scrum. I meet companies in the Daily Scrum. It's an article, scientific article that studied that, the behavior. So the daily is a moment that we are with the team, pre-pandemic stage, in the same room, and the Scrum Master asks the poll, then go to Philips, then go to André, then go to Sylvie. There is a study that says that that must be done different. The Scrum Master should walk on board. So you have the PBIs, the stories, the product backlog items, and the Scrum Master should take randomly this story. It's the, what about this story? Because the team get the focus and don't know what the Scrum Master will ask. And that study shows that when I ask first Paul, then I ask in the second moment the Philips. So Paul, it's already without attention. Okay, that was a study. So remember that these tools are obviously a support to maintain agile innovation alive. Okay, and of course it's agile innovation. If we can do, it's boring for me if I am in the other side of the world, wake up and I don't know about the teams, the project. I don't know the progress. I will call to the project manager or the Scrum Master or whatever, and but this time he is sleeping. So it's a real problem. We have to have the that's because in Scrum there is another thing called a definition of ready. It's important to have the roles of how you specify the task. It's very important to have the verbs to be assertive in the definition of the tasks. But just to say that I prefer absolutely the daily Scrum online with all the people. Okay, I prefer presentially, of course. One day we are in the Scrum, on the daily Scrum, and one worker are very angry. And we said, hey, what's happened? Why you are angry? And he tells to the team, I am bored too because I am doing PDF files since 2 weeks ago. And we say, okay, no problem. We can change the function to another colleague. So the simple feedback he gives with his behavior, with watching the ground, permits to delegate the functions to another person, and no problem, and is happier. So I prefer presentially, but if you have distributed teams, you can have this kind of tools to implement that techniques. Okay. They provide here also the templates and orientations. They have here the sprint review and some tools. Then we have the mission three. There are four: collaboration, connection, intentionality, and sustainability. This is from the mural again. There are other recommendations for post-pandemic stage, the new era, the new normal. And sometimes it's not easy to say change to digital. So we need intentionally to provide system and process around the new reality of work. One client told me one day, Pedro, I don't care about the price. If the software is good, people use it. So it is not enough to appear intentionally. It must be. Okay. So if you have the good tools, the things will be achieved and used. And the last one, sustainability. But it is always difficult to shut off after a long day of work. And when our office is our dining room table, sliding in to working 12 or 14 hours a day can happen almost without notice. So it happened to me, happened to you. So it's to identify and tackle negative trends in happiness before they become a problem. Sometimes it's difficult to turn it off, to shut down, because it's just one thing, just one thing, just more one thing. It's the last thing, and that's a problem. So the recommendation is empower the teams to ensure they are keeping a sustainable pace. Ask for ways to improve work-life balance. It's very important. And listen to the answers. And some companies provide and prioritize the well-being of its employees, and that was very important. So, if you remember, I said in the beginning, innovation is do what people like. So, it's important to measure how they like the company, how they like to work. And I have here, sometimes I measure the happiness. It was amazing, this measure. I give a post-it for each one. And in a scale 1 to 5, they show the happiness, the level of happiness with the correct function. Okay. In the left side, you have software that do that, but in the right side, that's how we measure. And the people justify that blue guy put 3.5, and I ask why, and he said because this week doesn't have any holiday, non-working day. So we smiling, we are happy with that. Of course, it's more important if anyone is unsatisfied to learn fast and improve fast. So know fast and improve fast as quick as possible. And sometimes there are many simple things we can do to innovate. And that's here I close my presentation about agile innovation. Measure, okay, measure to improve it. And thank you all. And I am available for some question and answers. If you have, I hope I'm not boring, but we the good news is we have to the end. I hope you like. I am always available to.
Yes, thank you. I believe that you're also available by email if there's some question or comment later on. So we have your contact, and maybe you can share your presentation.
Sure.
We
I
can
send you.
We can share it with everybody who attended.
Yeah, because if there are some lags,
And we share the link to
okay.
the video also.
Okay.
Thank you
Okay.
very much. Thank you
Thank you,
very much.
Katarina. Thank
See you
you.
next time. Bye bye.
Bye. See you. Thank you. Bye.